بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهداه. Today inshallah I'd like to talk about or under the title, the following title, لا تعارض بين التوكل على الله والأخذ بالأسباب. Adopting means to reach an end or to reach a goal does not contradict with trusting in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At-tawakkul, trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or depending on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is part of al-iman. Al-iman, we know that's more than 60 ranks or 60 levels, and at-tawakkul ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one of these rings and this level. And to follow al-asbab, to follow or to adopt, or adopting means and methods does not contradict with at-tawakkul, and also to do your best, not only to depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to take al-asbab or to follow the means, not that only, also to do your best in adopting the means and following the means is part, does not contradict with al-iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to depend on him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah jalla jalaluhu said in al-Quran al-Kareem to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was our example and role model to follow alayhi salatu wa salam, لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم وشاورهم في الأمر فإذا عزمت فتوكل على الله إن الله يحب المتوكلين. The translation of the meaning of this ayah, Allah سبحانه وتعالى commanded the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to consult them, أي الصحابة, the companions رضي الله تعالى عنهم. He told him, consult them in the affairs. Then when you have taken a decision after consultation, if you conclude or come to a decision, then put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Certainly Allah loves those who put their trust in him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this ayah is clear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to consult, and this is kind of adopting the means. And when they come to a decision, then after this decision, put your trust. So this, the first step is following the following and adopting the means, and then at the end, we should trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and depend in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of as-sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in came to al-masjid and came to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from outside of al-Madinah. He wasn't from al-Ansar or from al-Muhajirin. He was from outside of al-Madinah. He came riding a she camel. When he reached al-masjid, when he reached al-Madinah, he met Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he left his she camel outside. Then he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Ya Rasulullah, aqiluha ay linnaqa wa atawakkal aw utliquha wa atawakkal?" Qala alayhi salatu wasalam, qala lahu, "Aqilha wa tawakkal." Rawahu Tirmidhi wa hasanahu al-Albani. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this man, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "O Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I have my she camel outside. You want me to tie its rope, to tie her with the rope, or you want me to let her free, to release her or keep her independently? Then I depend in Allah and I trust Allah with this she camel." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him clearly, "Aqilha wa tawakkal." No, tie the she camel, then depend. And depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This authentic hadith is as the ulama or muhaddithin yaqulun, nassun fil mas'ala. is the answer of this question, is the answer of the title and the subject that I am talking to you about it today. And if you want to define at-tawakkul, if you want to know what at-tawakkul is علم القلب وعمل القلب. At-tawakkul is the knowledge of the heart and the action of the heart. The knowledge of the heart that the Muslim and the believer must believe that النفع والضر بيد الله سبحانه وتعالى is to know, your heart to know, your heart has to know that nothing can bring benefit or turn away the harm from you without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means the benefit and the harm is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the knowledge of the heart. And the action of the heart is to depend in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عمل القلب is التوكل, is to depend in Allah and to trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one of the actions of the heart. If the action of the heart goes to the right direction and depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that affect the action of the body or al-jawarih, which is to adopt the means and to follow the means until you reach your goal and your end. From here, the scholar said, if you depend on the means, this is shirk. And if you does not follow, or if you don't adopt the means, this is ta'til al-shara. Ta'til al-shara or qadhum fi shara. Qadhum fi shara means as if you are accusing our deen, our sharia is not complete. So it is very dangerous or sensitive issue. If you claim that al-Islam does not care about adopting the means or following the means, as if you are accusing Islam is not complete, and that some ulama, they called he is fasiq. Al-fasiq is the one who does not follow the teaching of al-Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in al-Quran Kareem, وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إلا أن يشاء الله رب العالمين وقال سبحانه وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء الله إن الله كان عليما حكيما in سورة الإنسان. The translation is and you cannot will unless Allah wills. Verily Allah is ever all knowing and all wise سبحانه وتعالى. This ayah confirmed and affirmed the will of the people. يعني هذه تثبت مشيئة الإنسان. But our will cannot be outside or under the knowing or control of Allah's will, is under Allah's will سبحانه وتعالى. If we use our will in haram, Allah سبحانه وتعالى will ask us and punish us. Or if we don't use this will in right direction, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us. And if we use this will in the right direction, in the goodness and in halal way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us. Ikrima, one of great tabi'in, rahimahullah, one of the students of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said, in this life, no one everyone get happy or sad. But if we use the happiness, or if we consider the happiness with thankful to Allah, and the sadness with patience, that means use the happiness and be thankful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you face or if you are happy, and if you are sad, be patient. In this case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you, and that's kind of at-tawakkul ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Uh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also has said in Al-Quran Al-Kareem, ما أصاب من مصيبة إلا بإذن الله. ما أصاب من مصيبة إلا بإذن الله. ومن يؤمن بالله يهدي قلبه. والله بكل شيء عليم. SubhanAllah, this is a great ayah. All the ayat of Allah are great. The translation of this, or the meaning of this ayah, no calamity befalls unto us, unto everybody, but with the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but with the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His divine decree. Nothing can happen to anybody. Any calamity befalls into anybody cannot be without Allah's decree, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whosoever, to finish the ayah, and whosoever believes in Allah, Allah guides his heart to the true faith, to the true iman. And Allah is the all-knower of everything. If you pay attention, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَمَن يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِي قَلْبَهُ. Any calamity happen to anybody of us cannot be without Allah's decree. And whosoever believes in Allah, Allah guides his heart. That means when you face this calamity, this problem, this hardship, this disease, this plague, with believing in Allah, what that means? That means nothing can happen without Allah's decree. مُؤْمِنًا كَمَا فِي حَدِيثِ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم مُوقِنًا بِأَنَّهُ لَا يُصِيبُهُ إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. Yani we have strong belief that nothing can happen to you with full yaqeen but what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed on us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide our heart to be relaxed to the faith, يَهْدِي قَلْبَهُ, to the true faith, to the tranquility, that what we need. Also, in the same regard, the accepting the qadr and the qada and the divine decree, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us in another authentic hadith, warda bima qasama Allah lak takun aghna an-nas. Nabi alayhi sallam said in this hadith narrated in Muslim Imam Ahmad and Sunan Tirmidhi wa Hasanahu Albani, also Albani grounded as Hasan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and accept and be satisfied with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided for you, especially at the level of provision, you will be the most richest one with al-qana'a, with al-rida. And Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, Shaykh al-Islam, he said, al-i'timadu ala al-asbab shirkun wal-i'radu anha qadhun fi shara. And I mentioned that if you depend in al-asbab, that's kind of shirk. But if you reject, or you did not follow and adopt the means, that's as if you are accusing our deen, as if it is not complete. And also Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, said, لَا تَتِمْ حَقِيقَةَ التَّوْحِيدِ إِلَّا بِمُبَاشَرَةِ الْأَسْبَابِ التي نصبها الله وأن تعطيلها يقدح في نفس التوكل. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah said, the true tawheed, the true iman cannot be completed if we do not adopt the means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created and ordered us to follow. And if you reject this means, you don't want to follow this means, that you are that effect at tawakkul itself. Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, the one who explained Sahih Bukhari, he mentioned hadith, not hadith, an incident with Al Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah. He said he was sitting in his masjid, and a man came, and he asked him. He said, "I don't want to do any job, any work. I don't want to do anything, and I want to wait in my masjid or in the masjid. I want to wait until my provision comes to me." And Imam Ahmad, rahimullah, said, "This man, jahil al-ilm, he's ignorant about the knowledge of deen. He doesn't know our deen. Because, Imam Ahmad said, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, indeed, Allahu ja'ala rizqi tahta dhilli rumhi. Yani, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa said, Allah made my provision under the sword, under my sword or under my spear. And this is kind of asbab. And also, Imam Ahmad said, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said, al hadith al ma'ruf al mashhur, the known hadith, لو توكلتم على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطيرة تغدو خماصا وتروح بطانا. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in this hadith, if you depend on Allah, the true, the complete dependent. If you trust Allah completely, full trust of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide you, will take care about your provision, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took care about the birds. And the hadith does not end here. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam continued this hadith. The bird in the morning, even before the sunrise, will leave their nest, their places, hungry. Their stomach are empty. And these birds will go the morning with empty stomach and come back at the evening with full stomach. So Imam Ahmad said, this is the true tawakkul. You have to follow the means. You have to adopt and to do some the work. So this is the tawakkul in al-Islam. Lastly, I'd like to mention something related to treatment. To take the medicine and to treat yourself and to go to the doctor and to get the medicine from the pharmacy and to do the surgery if you need it, etc. It is in our deen and it is permissible in our sharia. And that absolutely does not contradict with depending on Allah and trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the proofs and the dalil of these mas'ala and this issue, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about al-ruqa and al-adwiya, when the Prophet ﷺ, when the Sahaba asked the Prophet ﷺ about al-ruqya and taking the medicine, the Prophet ﷺ said, "Hiya min qadar Allah." Hiya min qadar Allah. When you take the medicine, and it is part of Allah's qadar decree. That means if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, will make this medicine treat you and cure you. So this is by qadarullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because I'd like to emphasize one meaning here. Nothing, and again, nothing can be happened in this world, in this universe, without the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without Allah's knowing and Allah's knowledge subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إن الله أنزل الداء والدواء وجعل لكل داء دواء. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said in this hadith, Allah sent down the illness or the disease, and also sent down the treatment of it. And He make a treatment for each disease. Each disease has a treatment. And as I mentioned from before, there is another narration, عَلِمَهُ مَنْ عَلِمَ وَجَهِلَهُ مَنْ جَهِلَ. Some people know this medicine or treatment, and some people does not. Some country they know, in some country does not. Then the Prophet ﷺ, the same hadith said, فَتَدَاوَوْا وَلَا تَدَاوَوْا بِالْحَرَامِ. So treat yourself, take the medicine, try to cure yourself, but don't use haram medicine or haram way in your treatment. This hadith narrated in Sunan Abu Dawood. Also, Usama ibn Shuraik, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, the Bedouin or Al-A'rab asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said, Ya Rasulullah, ala natadawa? Is okay to treat ourselves and to take medicine? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, tadawaw, fa'inna Allah lam yada' da'an illa wada'a lahu shifa'an illa da'un wahid. Qalu ya Rasulullah, wa mahu? Qala al-haram. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam said, no, you can't treat yourself. Go and treat yourself. The Prophet said, encourage them to treat themselves. Because Allah, he said, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Allah, he made a treatment for each illness. Each disease has a treatment, except one. They asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what is this one? What is this illness or this thing that there is no treatment? There is no treatment for it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al-haram." Al-haram, the old, when somebody come to the old age, because the old age, the old man, there is no a medicine for the old man to take. Then he becomes or she becomes young. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Give up of this." Give up to find a medicine to make the old man as young man. If somebody is 80 years old, cannot be 18, for example. Al-Hadith narrated in Sunan Tirmidhi, and he graded as Hassan. And also, I'd like to remind you too that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used al-hijama many times. Ihtajama Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam many times. And some of this narration in Ramadan, and some when he was traveling, and when he was home in Al-Madinah, Rasulullah used Al-Hijama many times. And Al-Hijama, not only a treatment, it's the best treatment. It's kind of treatment, and it's fine of following and adopting the means. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it. That's what I'd like to say in this quick khatira. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take this hardship away soon, and treat all the people, Muslim and not Muslim, and take this plague from al-bilad wal-ibad, from the all the country. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow his mercy and his forgiveness on us. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.